everyone, it's Lisa from Canine Clips Dog Grooming Tips, and this little shy girl is Harley. She is a Biewer Yorkie, and she's coming for her full groom, but she is a little bit of a nervous Nelly. So it just takes a little more time to groom her. That's a good girl. So I'm going to try using a 3 3/4 on her. I'm going to start with a number 5, just that I see the mats here. And matting in the legs is quite common. And that kind of determines the length you're going to go when you're trimming your dog. Because it's just too painful to comb all that out. Alright, so let's get started. So I'm going to start with the number 5. So I'm not going to use any restraints, and there'll be no editing to the film. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. And if you do, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate that. And always let me know in the comments what you think, and also if you have any ideas for any other videos you'd like to see. I do have quite a variety of playlists that I've created on my channel, so I've separated it out by dog breeds and the length of the groom and difficulty of the groom, so hopefully you'll be able to find what you're looking for. But if there's something else you'd like to see on there, just let me know. Going to add some oil. Okay. I'll do that front leg, and then I'll just use the scissors on the feet. Just try to keep her this way. Makes it a little harder when they lay down like this all the time. Hard to get in those areas. There we go. While I trim her feet. No, goodbye. Thank you, little girl. No escape for you. I know you don't like it. You gotta get it done. Hey. Harley. You're fine. Harley, stop. No. You know what you're doing. Nope, stay. Hey, stay. Hey, come here, baby. Stay. That's still not. Just try the other way then. Oh, you're so cute. No, she's using a little bowl. Well, I guess that still works. Okay, one more. There you go. Good girl. Hey. Harley, stay. You're gonna tire yourself out, little lady. You got the good moves. Yeah, you're getting tired. Key is just to keep on doing what you're doing. Let them squirm if they have to, but I'm always holding on to where I need to work on. So even though she squirms, she doesn't really get away. And then once she takes a break, when I keep doing mine. Hey, Harley. No, you're not getting away. Hey, no, stop it. You're fine. Hey, stay. Tired puppy after. All your extra work out here. That's a good girl. Okay, all better. Okay, so I'll get back started here on the body. Now that's pretty cute. You're so funny. She just crawled out. And you're tired. Too bad. We'll see how it goes for the trimming of those paws now. She looks so innocent there. Hey. Now we'll do the back one first. Usually the front ones are always a little bit more of a challenge. I've got a good angle for the camera. He's thinking about it. Just a slight resistance here. Okay, there you go. Okay. That was much nicer. Let's see if we can do the front leg like that. So sometimes when they're difficult on one side, if you stick with it and they realize you're not going to stop, second side might be a lot better. Plus they're got a little tired from the resisting the first time, so much better on this one. So that's nice to see. It's all about about consistency. It's gonna be persistent, and when they are, they're acting out. It's just keep following through, and don't stop until you're done whatever stage you're at. Consistency will help them to, not necessarily not be more nervous, but be more compliant so that you can do what you got to do so they can get out there, get out of here faster. Okay, I'm going to trim up the bum area. Okay. Unique poses there. Okay, on to the face. bit of staining here. As she gets a little older, because she's just over a year now, as she gets a little older, her resistance will be a little less and less. You know, she still may be nervous because many dogs don't like being groomed. They'd rather be home, snuggling on the couch. Trying to compare it to us going to the dentist. We don't like it, but we have to go. And once we're done, we feel a lot better. But we still don't want to go. Always nice when they kind of relax in the second half. Of course, it's even nicer when they are relaxed from the very beginning and I don't have to struggle with it a little bit. But this just shows that she will get better and better over time. So you get half of a difficult groom and half of a little bit more relaxed groom. So, but same dog, so kind of impressive how fast they can change. It's just sticking with it, like I said. It's all about being consistent and not giving up when they are resisting so much. Because if you give in to it, it just reinforces that behavior and lets them know that if I tug or nip or yelp or try to get away enough, they'll eventually stop and leave me alone. But if you stick with it, they'll tire out eventually, but so will you. But you'll still know that you are the one that is in control. There we go. Okay, baby. Time for your bath. Her ears too, so I'll have to go back and do that after. But she actually didn't really have too much hair in there, so thankfully it should be pretty easy to get that done. Good girl, that's really good. Okay, we are ready for the rinse off. Thank you. apron when I dry. Let's see how she does. Another one that I actually created a playlist for, because she was a very difficult dog the first time I groomed her, and so I started a playlist to show her progress, so you can see from a very difficult puppy to a little bit difficult at the beginning, but much better as she comes consistently. Her owners do bring her regularly for her grooming. So that makes all the difference to get your dog much more comfortable. Just make sure you don't wait too long, like, so that they're not too old for their first groom. Ideally, kind of at the 12-week stage, well, you can bring them just for a trim. But just get them used to the clippers and stuff when they're younger. Yeah, about that 3-month stage though. Let's think she was a little older when she first came, so she was a little nervous and a little jumpy on me. Lots of energy. So I will attach her first groom at the end of this one. But if you want to see all her progress, you can go to her playlist on my channel. It is named Harley, Biewer Yorkie. And her progress. So because there is some matting in the legs, that's why the top, I'm kind of going back and forth to get a little bit more off, but still keep a little bit more length than the legs. So I don't want to use a number 5 on the top because that would take quite a bit off. But she's got quite a bit of curl there. Hey, where are you going? You're a little girl. You got some strength. It's so funny how they can maneuver on me with their little bodies. That's why I kind of switch it up a little bit. There we go. Maybe right there. Okay, let's do those ears. Like I said, a little bit of hair in there, but really not too much. The ears look really nice and healthy. But there is a little bit of wax buildup on those ears, so it is good to get that hair out. So that doesn't have anything to stick to. Once I put that solution in there, it'll loosen up anything that's maybe stuck in there, and she'll be able to shake it out. Keep those ears nice and healthy. There we go. Okay, put her ear solution in. I know. Yeah, good girl. I just want to see her top of her head there. Yeah, I'm just gonna trim it a little bit more. Get a little bit more layering in there. She'll be all done. So I hope you enjoyed the transformation, and not only of her grooming, but also of a difficult dog to a more compliant dog. It just needs a lot of consistency from you as a groomer or an owner working on your dog and just following through with whatever you're working on. You'll for sure take lots of breaks if you need to, but just finish whatever process you want to get done. And when they are compliant and, you know, relaxed or calm or just tired but not struggling, that's when you can take a break. Not when they're in the middle of it, because that just reinforces that behavior. So, but check out my other films and you can see all that. Yeah, you're all done. And like I said, I'll put her other video at the end of this one so you can see her first groom. And then check out her playlist where all her videos will be on there. And so you can see her progress to where she is today to where she was. All right, so thanks for watching, everyone. And we'll see you again soon.